insight to be equal. No disguise needed, a voice that finds reason to multiply people in the streets for the cause. Marching on Washington miners, we'll be walking through walls. Type of superhero show up when ain't no one to call. Better shield you from them shields that been killing us all. High beams for eyes to peek, the villains in the dark. Power of resolution for a war would even start. The knowledge to build and grow where they live and take care of the kids and the older folk. The clean cause they need it most. Politics.
For my money, it's the best time of the year. Playoff football time as postseason action descends upon FedEx Field just outside of D.C. Straight ahead, it's Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a great one in store between the Detroit Lions and the Washington Commanders. And off we go. We're underway in this NFC wildcard game. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Start this drive out on the ground. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. A good start. One play, 10 yards.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Second down. Howell back to pass. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Faking the handoff, Howell. Got this complete to Jahan Dotson. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Off play action. It's Howell. Flushed out right. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Well, sometimes the defense just beats you. Great coverage from the secondary, all of them in the proper position. So instead of trying to throw into tight coverage, he found a way to throw it away and come back and try again the next down.
And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. A strong pickup of 11 keeps their drive alive. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll get about three as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Here they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. The play fake, and now here's Hal to throw it. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Not a great start dropping his first target, but let's face it, it won't be his last chance because he'll get opportunities to make up for that one throughout this game.
So Tyler Bass on now for the field goal. This will be a 34-yard attempt. The kick by Bass is good. Every possession in the postseason magnified. And look, it's just the opening drive. They didn't get the touchdown they wanted, but at least they got on the board.
They got on the board. They've got their home crowd into it as well. And remember, in the playoffs, the game slows down a little bit. So every point is precious.
So after knocking through the field goal, here's Bass to kick it away. From the six. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. Second and 10. A very chilly day here, but no snow. And I gotta say, if it's gonna be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy.
That's gonna win the game.
Throw. That's complete to the running back, Nyheim Hines. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Back to throw now on first down. Finds Hines again for the completion. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down to the hands of the wrong team.
They'll go play action. Howell. Flush to his right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
Now they go play action with Hal. Under pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. The offense on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 16. 3rd and long, here's Howell. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he's going to have a Commanders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he's got some space here. And a strong run there as he'll maneuver his way down inside the 15. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Here they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
They've created a nice sustained drive off of plays like that. A nice strong run there that keeps them advancing the ball.
From the 9, second and 5. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Isaiah Pacheco, a 9-yard touchdown run, as his guys are able to extend their lead. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And the lead grows to 10-0. To the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So, they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Yeah, he hadn't gotten far enough away from the pocket to throw that football away, and that draws the flag.
Yeah, the old tackle box, right? Get outside of each tackle, and then you can go ahead and throw it away, and you're in good shape. But if you're back there in the pocket, you got to make sure of what you're doing.
He'll get this complete to Jalen Reagor. You see what they have drawn out here, a little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. To throw. And that is incomplete.
Well, they moved the ball okay here in these first two drives, but this one's going to get them out to nothing. They've got to start dialing up some plays that allow them to finish drives with points.
Okay, right?
They're going to try and throw. That's to Amon-Ra St. Brown. And he is going to have the Lions first down as this defense cannot come up with a play that they need. In fact, they surrender a big chunk, 17 yards there on fourth down. They run with Hines. And some room to work. And a pretty good burst there as they'll get this across midfield and down to the 46. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. That'll be caught. Reagor with it. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Looking to throw. That's complete. It's Rashad Bateman. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Back to throw again. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Jalen Reagor from 6 yards away. And the Lions are back within a score. Bouncing back nicely from that bad opening drive where he threw the interception. Drive number two leads him right down the field and into the end zone.
So obviously his confidence was never lost, and that's a good thing to see. Great quality to have. You absolutely must maintain that as a quarterback. But I have to think that they're probably still on the script that they prepared for this game. Just the second drive, they've worked on these plays all week in practice. Put them to good use on that one.
So just a three-point game now as they send this one away. This will be fielded inside the five. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And they had the touchdown during the last drive, and I'm guessing that you like the balance they had on that last drive.
And I loved it. Forget liking it. Absolutely loved what they were doing, because to be ahead of the defense that much, where every play call you have, run or pass, is working pretty well for you.
Makes you look like a genius.
It really does. It also lets you know that your preparation was pretty good, and now the defense has to do all the adjusting.
Here's second and 10. Here's Hal to throw on second down. And this is thrown to the sideline. No receiver in the area, though, and that's going to bring out a flag. We saw it, too. Nobody in the vicinity of that throw, and that earns him the penalty.
Yeah, you've got to at least get it close enough to one of your own guys in order to dodge the penalty.
Do get 18, but even that won't be quite enough. It's fourth down. Going for it on fourth. Here's Hal. Slings this deep from McLaurin. And the defense loses him. It's complete. Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin, 75 yards. And the Commanders' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. The extra point by Bass, up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it's second down. They'll drop the throw. Rager catches it left side. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 7 yards there and a first down. They'll look to throw again. They'll find Hines out of the backfield. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
First and 10 here. And you know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost.
They'll bring a receiver in motion left. Again, he'll drop to throw. Forced out to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try to pick up another first down.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
Hauled in over the middle by Rager.
And they'll be stopped at the 28 on a play that started at the 14. They pick up 14. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Throw to St. Brown, complete on the left side. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 12 more yards there and another first down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
Going for Bateman, he's got him on the out route.
And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. A gain of 8 there on the 8th play of the drive.
Ready. Ball on the 8, 2nd and 2. Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts
as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half.
Only needing 2 yards on second down.
Back to throw here. His pass caught at the 4.
And the Lions are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll set up to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They're putting together a drive here in the final minutes of the half, but the coverage has been tight all game long, and they certainly want to keep them off the scoreboard here.
They'll go again from the 3 here on second and goal. He'll drop to throw. He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown.
Amon-Ra St. Brown.
In the final seconds of the first half.
And the Lions are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half.
No problem there on the extra point. And the lead's down to a field goal at 17-14.
So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Washington offense at the line and ready to roll.
And only 6 seconds on the clock, so time likely for just one play.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup as we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon getting set for quarter number three here. These two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. This one fielded at the 5, and he'll be out of bounds across the 25. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. And Charles, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year, haven't really had to deal with a lot of adversity at halftime, to be honest, but now here they are with their playoff lives on the line.
And I think when you're alluding to that interesting locker room, you're just wondering, how are they handling that bit of adversity that they're seeing right now? Because I think this is a team that has to look to lean on the veterans at this point. We know we're better than this. We've proved it all season. Let them disseminate that confidence through the locker room. But this opening drive, it'll be an important one for them to give them a little jolt of confidence moving forward.
A second down pass play now, but it's incomplete.
The goal is certainly to try to make a big play happen and come back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you open drive, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
They'll look to throw. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Good clean play. No flags coming out of the pocket of the officials. Turns into an incompletion, and that should get them off the field with a 3-and-out.
Here comes the Lions punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. This is brought in at the 21. So a good punt there, but a very strong 14-yard return. And the Commanders will take over with a first and 10. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. Faking the handoff, Howell. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. And they're going to get this up to midfield.
Sometimes it's design, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about 6.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Hands it off out of the gun. Asante Samuel Jr. that time up to make the tackle. And not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
On second and 9, Howell. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll get 7 yards from the 17 to the 10 before he's taken down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Third and one. Howell's going to throw it. Able to connect with Dotson. Touchdown. Jahan Dotson from 10 yards out. And they're able to add on to their advantage. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. This will be fielded inside the five. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. And they'll have good field position here as he's out of bounds up at about the 34-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They're down now 24-14. Work to do as they come up on a first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That's complete to his receiver, Bateman. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. They'll look to throw now on first down. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. He'll look to throw. And in for the Lions touchdown. Amon-Ra St. Brown with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Lions have cut it back within a score.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that into the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter, despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now they'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. Start on the ground here on first down. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
68 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
The play fake, and now here's Howell to throw it.
And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. They bring the safety on the blitz, and he busts through to drop him for an 8-yard loss. Throwing on second and long.
This is intercepted.
Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker.
And the Lions are going to take possession of the football.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Throwing here to start the drive.
That'll be caught. Rager with it.
A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28.
One
quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Second and one. He'll check this down to Hines. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. They'll look to throw here on first down. And he's got it. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Nyheim Hines, a 20-yard touchdown. And the Lions have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. Now the try here for the point after. And that will make this a four-point game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. If they want to advance in this divisional round, look, obviously the time is now. Trailing here in the fourth as they go to work on a crucial, crucial drive, first and 10. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Powell. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. Down the numbers. There he goes. Touchdown, Washington. Isaiah Pacheco. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Commanders use the defensive breakdown to take the lead away here in the fourth. Extra point by Bass. Up and good. And that gives him a three-point lead. To the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And this wild card game has been as good as advertised. They trail by a field goal here in the fourth, with obviously a very critical drive forthcoming as they start with a first down. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down. They'll set up a throw. This to Hines on the drop off. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. It's a gain of 14 and a first down for Detroit.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. They'll drop the throw. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. This offense so far on third down, just one for three thus far. This will be a tough third and 18. He'll look to throw. Open man right side is St. Brown.
And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts.
That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
A throw complete to the tight end, Tonyan. And he is trying to get to the marker. Going to depend on his spot, but I'm not sure he got there, and he did not. First and 10 here for Howell and the Commanders at the 41-yard line. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 87 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. Play action. Howell. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. Touchdown, Washington. Jahan Dotson, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Commanders get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a 2-score deficit. Throw right side. This is into the hands of the tight end, Tonyan. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Looking to throw. That'll be caught. It's Rager. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line. So they go from one 42-yard line to the other as they come up now first and 10. Buying time to his left. And he wisely will throw that one away.
Nice progress down the field. Was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
They'll look to throw again. This ball complete to Rager. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, you have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play, and he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. Back to throw again. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have gone out. Instead, it was a right-time collision to drive that one for
him. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions. Have him looking at third and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Amon-Ra St. Brown. Saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Lions have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Point after, right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. hands now as they line up and kick this one away. Fields it right around the goal line. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And this, a very important drive leading in the fourth quarter of this wild card game. But this one far from over as they start out here first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. So it's Commanders football as we get back to it. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Looks like he'll throw here. And he comes back with one complete. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Faking the handoff, Howell. Looking left sideline, it's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. First down, Howell. Escaping the pressure right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Second and 10, Howell. Complete. It's Dotson. He's got room at the 30. And some space here. A big pickup there. Without question, that should be more than enough to wrap this one up. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as it comes with exactly a minute to go in the football game. Now here's a handoff out of the gun. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it. Tyler Bass now for the point after. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Benjamin St. Juice, and the Commanders are going to take possession of the football.
Well, let's face it, Brandon. They're down here in the second half. Want to try and make something happen, and if you're the guy with the ball in your hands, you're going to try even harder, because I think all he was trying to do was to get outside the pocket and see if he can find a big play downfield.
Washington about to close this one out as they are down to a knee.
They said beginning of the season they wanted to get past the wild card round, and they just got past the wild card round.
How about that? Being able to put big check marks up in the locker room, right? Yeah, you